Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Well, a cool trick that I picked up at a seminar last week. I was doing a seminar at a company called BCG, and I was showing something about data entry here. So if we would enter the number 1 and press tab, and then 2, tab, 3, tab, 4, and now I'm in the last column, if I would press enter at this point, it'll jump back to the column in which I first started. So that's cool, but I always complain that if I make a mistake and use the left arrow key to go back to the column in which I made the mistake, correct it, now tab to column E and press enter, rather than jumping back to the original column, column B, it jumps back to the column in which I made the mistake. So I always kind of hate that method. Someone named Chris at that seminar raised her hand and said, wait a second, no, there's a way to do this. So we do 11, tab, 12, tab, 14, tab, and you realize you made a mistake. Well, she says, don't use the left arrow key, use Shift+Tab to go back, 13, tab, 14, and now press enter, and Excel will preserve the original column. So when you make a mistake using this technique, the cool thing to do is use Shift+Tab to go back, and Excel can still jump back to the original column. Cool way to go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.